Fishing for these coho salmon, it really pays to get out here early. Kind of like, you know, Lake Michigan is. Lake Superior, these coho salmon bite best from, you know, sun up right around 6 a.m. until noon or so. And then it kind of slows down after that for salmon. I mean, your trout will bite all day, but these salmon love the morning. So we got out here nice and early. The lake is calm. And we should be in for a good day. We're just trolling planer boards. We have three on each side. We're in Minnesota right now. We'll probably jump around and head across to Wisconsin. But Minnesota's two lines per person. Wisconsin's three. So right now we have six planer boards out. Varying anywhere from two colors of lead just up to straight mono. So we're covering that water column from 6 feet down to maybe 15 or so. And we have a lot of herring on the graph. So the bait fish is here. And the salmon shouldn't be far behind. This time of year, I mean, the water's still only 37 degrees. So our lake trout aren't up high yet. Our lake trout are still on bottom. You know, and as we progress into late April and May here, our lake trout will begin to rise. But our lake trout are still glued to the bottom. So, you know, if one of our lines gets hit, it's a pretty good chance it's gonna be a salmon. And these are coho salmon. There's king salmon in Lake Superior here as well. But we usually don't see those until, you know, May, early June. But right now it's all coho salmon. And once you find them, you're usually in for a good day. But it usually takes, that first fish is always the hardest out here on Lake Superior. Stay with us, hope it'll be a fun one.
When we care about something, it shows. To help protect these things, call on the knowledge and experience of a local independent insurance agent that you know and trust. Some things we just can't afford to lose, and that is why we exist. Because the worst brings out our best. Holden Insurance, Duluth and Superior.
It's summer again at Marine General, and we're here to get you on the water.
Kayaks, canoes, and paddle boards. Water sports, knee boards, wetsuits, ropes, and leg vests. Rain gear. Marine safety. Electronics of all kinds. Rods and reels. Trolling motors. Rod holders and all kinds of accessories for your boat. Live bait. Lures. And a crew that appreciates your business.
RJ Sport & Cycle, headquartered in Duluth, is the premier Lund boat dealership in northeastern Minnesota and northwestern Wisconsin. We carry a widespread selection of aluminum and fiberglass fishing boats, so whether you are an inland lake fisherman or a Great Lakes guru, we have the perfect boat to fit your needs. From tillers to side consoles and full windshield models, we sell them all. Browse our available models online at rjsportandcycle.com or stop into our store today to view our extensive selection of all things fishing.
Markham Technologies unleashes GPS with the release of the RT9, the first to combine sonar, underwater camera, and navionics mapping in a 9-inch ruggedized touchscreen tablet. Built on the Android operating system, the Wi-Fi-enabled RT9 can be used as a standalone tablet or snap into the cradle or performance pack for unmatched portability. Ice Electronics, the way they were meant to be. Sonar, GPS, underwater camera, one unit. Experience the RT9 from Markham Technologies.
There's a nice salmon. Again, it pays to get out here early. Right away, I don't even think it's 7 o'clock yet. And we have a coho on the line. Wee-hoo!
gotta wrap again, eh?
The orange jointed. That's what it takes. Look at that. Beautiful salmon. First one of the morning. It's a nice little guy. They definitely get a lot bigger than this, but that's a good start. It's all about kind of finding your area and putting a pattern together on where these fish are gonna be and what they're gonna bite on. You know, it takes, you know, it can take some searching and some, you know, changing lures, changing speeds, changing depths, but once you find what they're gonna bite on, you can usually replicate that on your other lines and have a good day with these fish. There we go. We'll put him in the box. That's some good eating right there. Nice little one to start the morning off. Drag just went off on that outside board, indicating to us that, you know, there's additional weight on the line. So it's most likely gonna be a fish. I mean, there's a small chance that it could be some debris in the water. We're fishing kind of on the entrance to these, you know, the river mouths here that flow into Lake Superior. So there's a lot of debris in the water, but it hit pretty hard, kind of like a salmon would. So what we're doing right now is just clearing our two inside boards, just so we have direct access to our outside board. And there's a couple of different ways to rig your planer boards up. I mean, you don't necessarily have to bring all your board, you know, your inside boards in to reel in your outside one. It's just kind of personal preference, and that's what I prefer to do. Just so, you know, we're not gonna get tangled, but some guys will rig up their planer boards where the line will pop out of their front clips and the board will drag back to the center, but you just have to ensure that it's gonna skip over your other two lines. So I just prefer to clear the inside boards. It doesn't take much. Adds about 2 minutes to the process, which isn't too bad. Decent Lake Superior Coho salmon. Woohee! That orange jointed scatter wrap. Day in and day out, it proves to be the best lure. I mean, anything bright colored. And these salmon seem to like these scatter wraps. Yeah, nice little salmon. They definitely get bigger than this, but that's a good start to the morning, so. Orange jointed. Oh yeah, there's a salmon. That's a salmon.
Yeah, switch those lures up and...
Yeah, it didn't take too long on that lure.
We got one, huh?
On the pink.
On the pink dots.
Yeah. Very nice.
Just like that.
Another average salmon for Lake Superior here. I mean, it's nothing. It's not like Lake Michigan. You're not going to get your huge ones, but these small coho salmon, I mean, they're as good as it gets for table fare, and they're fun to get out here and catch, and you can really, you know, catch a ton of them throughout the day. So it's kind of cool. People don't really realize there's, you know, beautiful salmon like this in Lake Superior right out of Duluth, Minnesota. So they are strong and feisty.
Oh, got that one out.
Yeah.
That's gonna be some good table fare tonight.
Yeah, that'll taste good. Get him in the live well. Thank you. This time of year, the majority of our salmon are up high, but when those fish kind of slow down, keep in mind that you always have lake trout on bottom that are gonna bite. So if your planer boards slow down and you have a couple downriggers on your boat like we do here, run a downrigger ball right next to bottom. And it always saves the day if your planer boards are kind of slow. And we've been plucking off a few salmon up high, but it's always fun just to put a lure right on bottom and catch lake trout. There it is back there. Want to net it?
Yep.
All right. And that right there is your classic Lake Superior lake trout that lives on the bottom. More of a siskoet type of fish. You can see how short their noses are. That's because they're down in the rocks eating, you know, eel pout and other minnows that live down there. But, and these fish will stay on the bottom all year round. It doesn't matter if the water is cold like it is right now, 37 degrees, or in the summertime if it's 80. I mean, these fish are always, it's a different species of trout that's always right on bottom. So if you're out here fishing for salmon with your planer boards up high, and that's kind of slow, put a rod right next to bottom. And these lake trout will eat it. What we're doing here is we fish this area for maybe 45 minutes or an hour with zero results. So we're gonna pick up and run maybe, I don't know, anywhere from 1 to 5 miles in the other direction. I mean, without getting the fish in a while, that kind of tells me there's really nothing in this area. We haven't really marked any significant bait. The water's just kind of the same color. It's cold, so it's just kind of, I don't know, to me it just feels kind of like a stale area. So rather than keep our lines in and, you know, troll at 3 miles an hour, we're just gonna pick up and get the big motor going, and we can get there a lot faster. Just kind of, if you're not catching fish in the area, you know, it's hard to have patience out here, so it just pays to, you know, just kind of run to the next spot and keep bouncing around until you catch fish. So let's hope it pays off.
When we care about something, it shows. To help protect these things, call on the knowledge and experience of a local independent insurance agent that you know and trust. Some things we just can't afford to lose, and that is why we exist, because the worst brings out our best. Holden Insurance, Duluth and Superior.
It's summer again at Marine General, and we're here to get you on the water.
Kayaks, canoes, and paddle boards, water sports, knee boards, wetsuits, ropes, and leg vests, rain gear, marine safety, electronics of all kinds, rods and reels, trolling motors, rod holders, and all kinds of accessories for your boat, live bait, lures, and a crew that appreciates your business.
RJ Sport & Cycle, headquartered in Duluth, is the premier Lund boat dealership in northeastern Minnesota and northwestern Wisconsin. We carry a widespread selection of aluminum and fiberglass fishing boats. So whether you are an in-the-lake fisherman or a Great Lakes guru, we have the perfect boat to fit your needs. From tillers to side consoles and full windshield models, we sell them all. Browse our available models online at rjsportandcycle.com or stop into our store today to view our extensive selection of all things fishing.
Markham Technologies unleashes GPS with the release of the RT9, the first to combine sonar, underwater camera, and navionics mapping in a 9-inch ruggedized touchscreen tablet. Built on the Android operating system, the Wi-Fi-enabled RT9 can be used as a standalone tablet or snap into the cradle or performance pack for unmatched portability. Ice Electronics, the way they were meant to be. Sonar, GPS, underwater camera, one unit. Experience the RT9 from Markham Technologies.
Out here on Lake Superior, you want to be as safe as you possibly can, and especially early season like this, April, May, June, that water is frigid cold. Right now we're at 38 degrees, so if you fall in, I mean, it's your muscles are going to lock up and you're not going to be able to move. So you always want to be sure to wear a life jacket, and Onyx makes these life jackets that are inflatable. You don't even realize you have them on right now. I mean, they weigh virtually nothing. If you fall in the water, they inflate and you're gonna float there so your buddies can turn around and pick you back up. So, I mean, you're fishing with downriggers, you're leaning over the side of the boat, you're taking planer boards off, and you're out here on Lake Superior, a lot of times there's big waves. I mean, things can go south fast, let's just say that. And this water's always, always super, super cold. So wearing a life jacket's an easy way to, you know, increase the level of safety out here on Lake Superior. Lake Superior Coho Salmon. If you haven't done this before, grab your walleye boat. You don't need a big boat to come out here and catch these salmon. And you don't need to drive to Lake Michigan. Lake Superior, right here in Duluth, April, May, June, woohoo, is, come here buddy, the best time to catch these salmon. They are fun. You can really rack up a number of them in a day. And the best part is, you know, as we progress into mid-April here, your king salmon will move in here, your lake trout, they'll all be grouped together. So this is just the start of this bite, and it's only gonna get better from here. Beautiful salmon, fun. I think we found a decent spot here. Finally, we find an area that has more than one salmon in it. And I just got this rod back out, and not 5 minutes later, it got hit again. And I mean, that's usually what it's like, is you find the fish and you get a bunch of them in a short period of time. I mean, it's really uncommon, kind of what's been going on here today, but as I was saying, you just never know. But it's nice we kind of found a little group of them here and got a pattern going, and it seems like two colors of lead with a bright colored lure such as orange is really doing it. That's a little bit bigger one. That's a nice salmon. It's a little bit bigger. It's probably pushing that 20 inch range, and I'd say usually on most years this is our average size. Just seems like this year they're running a little bit smaller, but they vary. That's a nice one. These fish are so cool. And all they're doing right now is just following the smelt in here. You know, our smelt run will start in a couple weeks here, and it just draws all these salmon and brown trout and walleyes and everything in. So yeah, that's a good one. Thank you. April is the time to get out here on Lake Superior and go after these salmon. And my favorite part about this time of year is you'll hook a fish and you don't know if it's gonna be a coho salmon, a king salmon, a lake trout, a brown trout, a walleye. All these fish are mixed in together chasing these smelt. And you never know what you're gonna get. After a while, you can start to judge by how a fish hits. This one, it didn't peel out drag. Usually a salmon will hit and peel out a bunch of drag right away. This one was more, a little more slow, so it might be maybe a lake trout or a walleye. We'll see here. I don't know what we have. Oh yeah, there's a small little. And that there is a Lake Superior coho salmon. Nice little guy. And although it may not look that big, the salmon out here on Lake Superior, I mean, if you get one that's 25 inches, that's a good one. So they average anywhere from 17 inches on up to, you know, 25. Sometimes you get them 26, but that's kind of rare. But I mean, that's a nice average salmon for Lake Superior here. And you can tell that they're coho salmon by the white gums inside their mouths, and your kings will usually be bigger, and they'll have black gums. So that's a nice one. We'll put him in the live well. And I mean, these are such good table fare. I mean, their meat is about as red or pink as you can imagine. I mean, it is so much fun. Beautiful. That's a good fish. We'll put him in the live well. And I mean, that fish right there, that probably won't even go over 2 pounds. But so you're wondering, you know, with all that line and these bigger rods, how can we tell that it even hit? Well, there's kind of a little trick, and that's to once you have your line out and your planer board out, you know, close the bail on your reel and turn the clicker on. Usually these trolling reels will have a clicker. And set that drag, you know, dial the drag back until you have line going out, and then slowly tighten it until it stops, so that any additional pressure whatsoever, you'll hear a little click. And for that fish there, I just heard a little, you know, it was 5 or 10 little drag clicks, and I knew that there was additional weight on there. Without that, I would have never known that fish was there until we were bringing in our lines at the end of the day. So, I mean, that's an extremely helpful tip to utilize out here, especially early season like this with these smaller salmon. So just getting our lines back out here, and we looked back on the horizon, and you know, 500 yards back there where that salmon hit, there's a big band of dirty water, and that's what was holding that fish there. So we were just kind of trolling down the shoreline here, and we went maybe 20 minutes without a fish, and the water was, you know, it was pretty clear, but then we got into that really dirty stuff, and that's where that salmon hit. So what we're gonna do is kind of make a big circle and go back through there, because we're at a kind of a river mouth here, and it's empty and dirty water, and that's where that fish was sitting. So usually where there's one salmon, you know, you're gonna have schools of, I don't know, 50 to 100 of them. So we're gonna swing back through there and see if we can't hook another one.
When we care about something, it shows. To help protect these things, call on the knowledge and experience of a local independent insurance agent that you know and trust. Some things we just can't afford to lose, and that is why we exist. Because the worst brings out our best. Holden Insurance, Duluth and Superior.
It's summer again at Marine General, and we're here to get you on the water.
Kayaks, canoes, and paddle boards. Water sports, knee boards, wetsuits, ropes, and leg vests. Rain gear. Marine safety. Electronics of all kinds. Rods and reels. Trolling motors. Rod holders and all kinds of accessories for your boat. Live bait. Lures, and a crew that appreciates your business.
Come on into Marine General and get
RJ Sport and Cycle, headquartered in Duluth, is the premier Lund boat dealership in northeastern Minnesota and northwestern Wisconsin. We carry a widespread selection of aluminum and fiberglass fishing boats, so whether you are an inland lake fisherman or a Great Lakes guru, we have the perfect boat to fit your needs. From tillers to side consoles and full windshield models, we sell them all. Browse our available models online at rjsportandcycle.com or stop into our store today to view our extensive selection of all things fishing.
Markham Technologies unleashes GPS with the release of the RT9, the first to combine sonar, underwater camera, and navionics mapping in a 9-inch ruggedized touchscreen tablet. Built on the Android operating system, the Wi-Fi-enabled RT9 can be used as a standalone tablet or snap into the cradle or performance pack for unmatched portability. Ice Electronics, the way they were meant to be. Sonar, GPS, underwater camera, one unit. Experience the RT9 from Markham Technologies.
Once again, just a small move warrants a fish. This isn't normal. Usually you find your salmon and you know you'll stick 4, 5, 6 of them in one area. But today it's you move spots and catch one and you move again and catch another one. We'll take it though. It's some days it's what you got to work with. It's just kind of adapting to what you're given on any day, because 2 days out here are never the same. Little coho on the orange. Bright colors. That's all it is. And this is on two colors of lead. So this lure is getting down there 14, 15 feet.